Here I am for round number one with blue-black control. I'm going to choose to play since I don't want to fall behind, and this hand is good. Some early defense, can cycle to try to find some action. I like this art on Island quite a lot. I'm going to cycle Floodwaters, but there's some chance I end up not cycling the Horror of the Broken Lands and just trying to cast that. Alright, well, I have plenty of good ways to deal with that. All right. Think I'll just make this trade, keep my life total high. And I intentionally didn't cycle either of my cards there just because, I mean, I have enough mana to cast them, and in all likelihood, the card that I would cycle into is going to be lower impact than one of these big 5-drop creatures. Alright, my opponent put one card on top and two in the graveyard. Okay. Well, I at least can play big monsters for the next couple turns of the game. Maybe that will be good enough to win. Sure. Ooh, that's a nice one. Remember that Horror of the Broken Lands gets pumped up by cycling or discarding, so hypothetically I can hit my opponent down to yuck. Okay, that's a setback. But what I was going to say is that once I can actually put two horrors into play and attack with them, I can really unload a lot of damage, like potentially 16 with just what I have in my hand. Okay. Well, I can still attack into that. And I think I'm okay with just dealing four here. What I really don't want to see is Floodwaters. That's a bit annoying as well. Okay. Well, now I need to start playing defense, unless I want to try to win in one shot with the horror. Yikes. It's a lot of big monsters, so maybe I should cycle something now. I guess I could also play Horror of the Broken Lands and try to block and cycle the Drake, or block and use Splendid Agony. So I'll just untap for now. Pretty weak draw. But if this works, I can trade with the two big creatures and then use some combination of the, well, I guess the Splendid Agonies to save myself from the flying creature, because I'm going to cycle the Drake. Wow. Well, this was a beating. I just played a 5-mana creature every turn of the game, and my opponent kept bouncing it and attacking me until I died. I could bring in Lay Bare the Heart. My opponent did seem to have kind of a high mana curve deck. Along those lines, Reduced to Rubble could be good as well. I think I'm not that interested in Illusory Wrappings. Alright, I'm going to try this. Splendid Agony was remarkably bad that game also. But I don't think I'm going to cut it until I know more about my opponent's deck. Man, this would have been good that game if every time my creature got bounced, I got to prevent my opponent from attacking me. Yeah, I'd say the strongest consideration is the reduce to rubble. I mean, just the reduce half of it, of course. I like this hand. These are two of the best cards I could see in my opening hand. Though the rags half didn't look like it was going to be that great against this opponent. I'll wait on cycling to get a little extra value. Well, I think I do want to cycle my fetid pools. Guess I could start with that. And then just swing for two. I'd rather try to get value out of this. This time I'll just pass with mana open. Sure. Two back on top. Alright, no trouble there. I can still block with Shimmer Scale Drake. I don't think there's any reason for me to rush things here. I can just pass as long as my opponent's not doing anything too nefarious to me. Okay. It's a very conservative non-attack from my opponent there. Sure. So we just have basically a stalemate here. I'm waiting to draw something. The Seeker of Insight's going to be good in a stalemate. I can cash this in anytime I want to kill the skirmisher and loot. I suppose I can play Festering Mummy now as a way to buy some time against Cryptic Serpent. So I take on a bit of risk if I block like this, but there's no instant speed removal in these colors. So I think the worst that happens is I get one for one here with a combat trick or a bounce spell. Okay. Go through the counter on Naga Oracle. Okay, well that's a good draw. I get to take away something, maybe the Angler Drake. I get to activate. Glyph Keeper is scary. But still, I'll take away the Angler Drake. My opponent could just embalm the Glyph Keeper anyway. Now, activate. No help there. And I'll wait a turn. Sure. Okay, this is getting ugly now. I really need some help. That's a good draw. Yeah, I suppose I just do nothing and use the Gale Strike. Use the Gale Strike and then loot with Seeker. Still trying to set up something with the Rags Riches. Like maybe if I draw a Splendid Agony, I can make something happen. All right, I guess I'm gonna start with Gale Strike on Cryptic Serpent. Splendid Agony. Now there is a draw. So keep in mind when I use Seeker that this is gonna get pumped up to 2/4. So one block that makes sense is something like that. I can also discard Rags Riches if I want to just skip right to the riches side of it. But that might not be necessary. Yeah, sure. Let's do it like this for now. Double Splendid Agony. So how does that change things? I guess I want to distribute some counters in such a way where more creatures will die when I cast Rags. So, for example, I could put like three on the Colossipede. Maybe I'll just Splendid Agony the Colossipede right now and then see what happens with the other. Right now I've got nine lands in play. All right. Okay. Now I cast Rags. And I get a loot. Man, really poor. Think I'm just going to block Naga Oracle and go to one. Okay, Cryptic Serpent, Weaver of Currents. Sacred Excavation, what does that do? Gets me back some cards that are not particularly helpful on this board state. I need to produce four blockers. So I'm going to start with Riches. Think I'm just in big trouble here because if my opponent gives me either of the tapped creatures, I don't have enough blockers total. If my opponent gives me either of the untapped creatures, I don't have enough flying blockers. But this does free me up to activate the Seeker looking for an answer. All right. Anything I can find? Can find my one of Winds of Rebuke. That's how I get out of this. And that's to say get out of this is a big stretch, because this is how I survive one turn, is if I cycle into my Winds of Rebuke. Well, I have to settle for another 0-1 draft, so not the best results to you anyway, and hopefully learn something. I'll see you next time.